guys, I hope this background and framework might have convinced you that I'm an avid reader. But to be honest, since my childhood, I've never been very keen towards reading a lot of books, and I've always been an outdoor person. But with times and during my early 20s, you know, I discovered that it's very good to have the art of storytelling with yourself, because that's what you get through reading a lot of books and novels. And also I discovered that having a good communication skills and a good vocab is also through reading a lot of books. So with time, I got indulgent to that. And talking about indulging, I think while having a long haul flights and having a long bus rides and train rides and having that weird eye contact with a lot of people, strangers, I decided to find an escape through books, and it did work out well. So hey guys, this is Shefali Singh and you are watching Travel with Shefali. So today I am going to extract some travel book recommendation for you guys. So first recommendation is Eat, Pray, Love. Oh my god, this book is very very dear to me. And so basically this is a travel memoir of this famous American author called Elizabeth Gilbert. So basically she sets out on a journey of self-discovery through across India, Indonesia and Italy, and she founds herself. It covers meditation, food and a lot of travel. Also, in a nutshell, it has given me a lot of life lessons that you just have to go and set out for that adventure and self-discovery journey, man. You just have to go and get out of your comfort zone. Second in the house, we have The Alchemist from Paulo Coelho. This is one of the best sellers across the world, and no doubt I just cannot stress over the fact that how beautifully written this book is, yet inspiring and enthralling at every new chapter. So basically this is a book of a shepherd's boy who dreamt to travel the whole world, and in order to follow his passion he took the sign of the universe. I mean, this is so magical. But yeah, he took every sign from the universe and followed it in order to pursue his dreams. It was such a nice journey, yet it had a lot of life-changing lessons at the same time. So if I have to put it, then this could be an amalgamation of self-help book along with travel journey. This book will also take you to a lot of new places and give you this comic charm along with a lot of goosebumps, to be very honest. So yeah, it's an enthralling ride of a book, and in the end, for me personally, it has given me the power of believing in my dreams and fulfilling my passion at the same time. So thumbs up for The Alchemist. Love the art of Paulo Coelho storytelling. I mean, how easily he sweeps into the story and give you that little life lesson that stays with you throughout the life. Third in the house, we have The Shooting Star by Shivya Nath. So again, this is a travel memoir of an Indian traveler who at the age of 23 decided to leave her comforting beds and comforting paycheck in order to travel the whole world. I mean, again, this book is about breaking the shackles and setting out and embarking your own journey, your own pathways, along with her backpack, of course. So apart from this, I think this book has given me a lot of solo traveler insight in India and across the world, and has given a different perspective of traveling, yet the stories are very 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 well written and enticing at the same time. I mean, it's very encouraging to pack your backpack and set out for a nomadic lifestyle full power. By guts. And this book does not only map out the world from an eye of a solo traveler, but it also gives you a little insight and the human spirit of taking that plunge and setting out on your own journey. Fourth, it's heavy. So basically this is India by Lonely Planet. I know you must be thinking that this is a travel guide, book recommendation, yada yada yada. Coming back to the point, this is, my friend, this is the Bhagavad Gita of traveling India, believe me. So basically, I'm an old school person in finalizing my trips and itineraries. So I like to get involved into the historical and cultural and geographical aspect of every place or any city. And having said that, yes, I could find that on internet, and I do use the internet for bookings and for a little bit of places, but before everything and anything, I go by this book, Lonely Planet Travel Guides for Any Place. And also, I think this is very beautifully written. It has encapsulated almost everything that a travel guide should have. It gives you everything, like food ke stalls se leke, souvenir shops se leke, coffee shops se leke, best coffee shops se leke, best accommodations tak. And also iske andar bahut sare chote chote geographic maps hain that can help you in order to finalize the place or the city or the anything yaar. Just have this. Fifth, we have the travel magazines. So basically, I love travel magazines. I just love them a lot. So basically, I love to read Condé Nast Traveler and Net Geo Traveler India. Both of the magazines have a different, peculiar way of looking at the travel. NGTI on one hand covers the stories that are more, you know, locally driven and give you that rawness of a story, while on the other hand, Condé Nast Traveler challenges the modern and the luxurious art of traveling across. So for me personally, I like the fact that I get the both perspective of any place before setting out an adventure, and it gives me the touch of local yet the luxurious travel, and which basically completes the trip for me, because I like to have both sides of the coin. Also, having said that, I think I just love the pages of these magazines. I mean, look at these buttery pages. And the pictures are so awe-strucking. I mean, who cannot have these? Yeah, who cannot? So yeah, if you like to read articles, then have these magazines. You will love them. I resonate with these magazines and their writing style and their covering story ideas. So this is an additional recommendation that I would like to give specifically to the traveler photographers who are a little bit inclined or who are a little bit inclined towards photography. This book is again by Lonely Planet. I think I can collaborate with Lonely Planet very soon. I've been recommending their books a lot. So I think I'm gonna collaborate with them. Touch wood on that. So yeah, this book is written by Richard Ironson, and I hope I'm pronouncing the name right. This book basically entails every possible composition, technique, gear, software, hardware, you name it, it has it. So just go and find this book for yourself, because this is the art of travel photography. And before that, just let me know if you're looking for any sort of different recommendation that I can provide you with, because I would love to give you, and I'm liking this process of giving a lot of different recommendations during the pandemic period. Okay, coming back to the thing. Alright guys, thanks for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed this, and if you do, then please don't forget to like and subscribe the channel and support the channel, and also just take care of yourself, be safe and sound, and I'll see you until the next video. Namaste.